And now, The Bonfire with Big J. Okerson and Dan Soder.
I really do think someone has a vendetta against me, because sometimes this volume in the headphones is turned all the way up, and I don't notice it until I put my headphones on, and then my ears hurt. Hi, I'm Dan Soder, and this is The Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. My sweet baby boy, Big J. Okerson, up in Montreal, Canada. He's in Montreal for Just for Laughs, The Nasty Show. You can see him tonight through the 27th. And don't forget, we're doing live shows from the Soprano Room C at the Doubletree next Tuesday through Thursday, July 25th through 6 to 8 p.m. So if you want to come just watch us do an episode, it's not going to be like a live show. It's going to be us doing an episode where you can just sit there and watch us if you're in Montreal. Soprano Room C at the Doubletree. Guest host, come on, Dog of Dogs, fucking Bullet Bulls, Shane Gillis.
Let's fucking get it, dude.
What's up?
Yo.
What's up,
what the fuck is up, Denny's?
The fucking meat of Mechanicsburg.
What's up, Denny's?
Oh, what the fuck is up, Denny's?
What is up, Denny's?
What's up, dude?
Chilling.
Matt and Shane's Secret Podcast.
Yes.
Go download it.
Yes.
Shout out McCusker.
Shout out Cusky. What up, bro?
Yeah. He's doing it.
He's doing it for real.
He's out in Philly taking care of business.
He's handling business right now. He's on his fucking bullshit. He's back on his bullshit.
Dude, we got a Lost Tapes coming up where Jay just out of nowhere realizes that I dress like Butthead from Beavis and Butthead. And then today, I'm not going to ruin it, but today I got on the train and stoned looking at my phone and a flock of Boy Scouts got on, and I look like a Boy Scout leader.
Oh, you do?
Yeah, with my wrestling t-shirt and my green shorts above my knee.
You do wear those socks. Let me see your socks right now.
I got black on black.
Oh, I like that. Oh, nice. Nike with? Yeah, dude. They look good.
Yeah. It's pretty good.
It's weird.
Pretty
good look. Shorts, you shouldn't...
I'm not a short guy. I don't have shorts. I tell Jay this all the time, because Jay's like, oh, so I wear jeans? I'm like, no, dude, you got calves like an elephant's heart.
Yeah, but ever since I watched that one episode of The Sopranos, they said, guys, don't wear shorts. I don't wear shorts.
The Sopranos got you to do that?
Yeah, I was young, and then someone was like, what's this guy, fucking gay? He's wearing shorts? And I was like, I'm never wearing shorts.
I'm picturing big-eyed little Shane eating cereal in front of the TV going, never shorts.
Never.
Never.
If the WAPs don't like shorts, dude, I don't like shorts.
They go, you got to cover up your leg noodles. Oh, man, I almost just... threw up.
Oh, it was sick.
I just had some tuna pop up.
Literally.
Literally. Sorry.
Yeah, sorry about that.
Dude, I realize the older I get, it's just burping and fucking almost puking is way more of a thing than it used to be.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, especially, yeah.
The lux, the reflux. You have it? You drink a lot of beer and you dip.
Yeah, I got it. I got the fucking, yeah, big
you got,
time.
You got your Luxin?
Yeah. I had to buy Nexium. I was very poor.
Yeah.
When I was in Philly, and that was McCusker's Bay got me that for my Christmas gift.
Was she got
Nexium?
Nexium. I used to buy Prilosec.
And that was big. That was a big gift.
Prilosec when I was drinking and I was a waiter, and it was just, I had fucking acid throat. I get Prilosec, but now I'm on. oh, God damn it. This is fucking awful. This is awful.
I fucking threw up this week.
Where?
I was back at my apartment.
Where you got hammered?
I was out partying. Yeah, dude.
Was it the Chappelle party?
Yes.
It was the night of Chappelle party.
Yeah, it might have been.
Sunday night?
Yeah, Sunday night.
Dave Chappelle had a comedian's ball in New York City.
Oh, it was cool.
It
was a lot of cool people.
Man, Shane and I are very similar in this. And you and Jay also agree. Cool parties aren't the best place for us.
I'm the worst with a cool party because I like a cool party if I have like a table in the corner and I can be away from it, but I don't like being in the mix at a cool party.
The last time I tried to go to a cool party was I got invited to Colin Jost and Scarlett Johansson's Christmas party. And I was like, why are you inviting me? Michelle Wolf was like, I'm going.
And I
was
like, she's cool.
But she's cool. And so I she likes being around the cool stuff. And so I showed up with her and I was like, I left. I left after like two drinks.
Just so wildly uncomfortable. That's such like a young hot girls game.
Yeah. I also bought a really bad sweater and I wore it.
Shout out Baby Girls.
Well, yeah.
It is Baby Girl Central. Yo, this party, Chappelle's party, was fucking wild.
Was it just infested with BBGs?
It was just baby girls everywhere.
Like Florida with iguanas?
It really was.
It's just baby girls everywhere.
There were so many baby girls that they were like, you're allowed to hunt them.
They were like, whack them on the head.
It was exactly like Florida.
You went back to caveman laws with getting women. They're like, just fucking whack them on the head. Listen, the Me Too thing's over. Just grab them. Yeah,
you walk in. You walk in. They hand you a pellet gun, and they're like, "There's a lot of them around here."
They go, "Listen, this is Viking law, so you're gonna need these. Viking, pick your queen."
But no, I was in there, and in the fucking invite, it was like, "Wear like a cool outfit," or like, you know, it said like dress like fucking nice.
I'm immediately out on a Sunday.
I was looking at it like, fuck. I don't have one. I wore my dad's Mechanicsburg Club bar polo.
What?
And jeans.
What?
The best outfit.
What? You dress.
I tried to dress up.
You dress up the way a dad dresses up to coach his son's football team.
I literally dress like a fucking coach.
You always dress like a coach.
Dude, it's game day.
And I have noticed the only time you wear shorts, they're like basketball football shorts.
Yeah, that's
right. Like football themed basketball shorts.
Exactly.
It's great, dude. Look at me. I look like a fucking scoutmaster.
I only wear gym shorts and coaches polos.
Yeah, you know, Jay takes some flack for the jorts going long, but it's better than a high knee than above the knee. Above the knee shorts, you got to be a hot boy.
Jorts are making a comeback.
Yeah, jorts have always been cool.
Jorts are hilarious.
I love a right below the knee jort.
I held on to jorts too long.
Can we bring back the Tommy Hilfiger carpenter shorts?
Oh, yeah.
Those are awesome.
We can do that.
You want to do that?
You and me can set some fucking trends.
Let's set some trends. Yeah, that's like bro-y get out of a rape.
Oh, like the pastel.
Yeah, that's like frat boy fucking my dad's a circuit judge look. Yeah. Or it's like southern, like we have a lot of fun and just drink. I'm talking about like, let's bring back jean shorts. Look up those.
Type in Florida Gator football fans.
Yeah.
All fucking jean shorts.
Do you think that's it?
No, for sure. That's people made fun of Florida fans for always wearing jorts.
They were known as the jean short fan base?
That fan base has jorts.
Oh, yeah. But see, those kind of jorts, I can't. Those are my jorts right there. I'll wear some butt crack. Tweet that out at the Bonfire SXM. Let's bring those back, Shane.
I've seen that. Yeah, go Gators.
So when they're cheering on Tim Tebow, they're just rocking jorts.
Everyone's praising Jesus and wearing jorts.
That's
winning championships.
That's a swamp weather and denim is rough.
Swamp,
swamp weather and denim.
Right down there, don't know,
guy. What are you doing? You put on your jean shorts? Daddy gonna sweat through this t-shirt like a damn gator coming out the water. Ooh, I love a thick old, thick-haired gator game in my jorts. Dude, I couldn't do that. I'd sweat my fucking ass off.
Yeah. I was close to wearing gym shorts here.
How close?
I had them on.
That feels so good.
Saw in the mirror. I was like, I can't wait. I was going to wear socks and sandals and gym shorts.
Oh, you're going full drug rehab look.
And then I was like, this is borderline disrespectful.
You should have had a pack of Marlboro Lights and a lighter and your keys.
Can of Skull.
Yeah, just show up with your keys and you're like, what's up, man? And I'm like, hey, you falling on rough times?
Nah, never been better.
Doing great.
This is a highlight.
This is the best. This is the best my life's ever been. Can you look up Tommy Hilfiger carpenter shorts? Black Lou. Were jorts were always popular. I feel like black dudes rock jorts all the time.
Yeah, mostly southern or lower.
Look at those. All lower. The way to the left.
Or lower what?
Not as wealthy.
Okay. So you're saying poor black people wear jorts.
Yes. 100%.
And poor white people wear jorts.
Yeah. Hey, look at that. Let's bring them everyone together. Let's start wearing jean shorts as a country. Maybe jean shorts bring this country together.
I swear to God, if you went to a Trump rally, you're going to see a lot of Trump. You're going to see a lot of jean shorts.
Cargo shorts, I'm out. I stopped doing cargo a couple years ago and I loved cargo.
Not a cargo guy.
I was deep in the cargo game.
This is my hometown.
What is that?
Dickie shorts.
Love a Dickie shorts. That's what kind of these are. These are Volcom.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Any sort of surf brand shorts.
Love them.
Big in the South Bay.
I'll fucking... But I need it right below the knee. I have too skinny a legs.
Look at this. See?
Yeah, that's exactly what I want to look like in shorts.
And then they wear long socks with like stripes on them.
I'm down. I'll do it. I mean, I have no calves, but I'll do it.
I'd like to dress like a fucking essay.
What's up?
Like,
yeah. Dude, what if I come with my arms down like this every time I see you? I'm like, what's up, homes?
What's up, homie? What's up, fool?
Yo, what's up, big sleepy?
Yo, I see you in the barrio, bro.
What's up, bro?
It's what's big? Good, Perro?
What's up, man? It's Gran Cabeza. What's up, bro? They call me Big Head.
Yo, what's up, Perro? You
what
crazy,
are you doing,
fool?
Bro?
Yo, where's your Hyena? Where's your fucking Hyena, fool?
Jay and I got replaced by two Vatos, just fresh out of the San Quentin. They're like, yo, bro, I fucking bust this white boy up.
I'm a big fan of the lads, dude. I forgot this is a,
dude, I,
my podcast.
I've told the story before on this show, but I was stoned and I went to go get a gallon of milk at Fry's in Tucson, Arizona. It was where the senator that got shot in the head, married to the astronaut. What's her name? It's pothead. Can't remember shit. It was at that Fry's. I mean, obviously not at the same time. This was years before.
Oh, fuck.
I gotta get milk. fuck.
Like, oh, there's a senator. Oh, shit.
There was Gabby Gifford. There was a person that was definitely like, fuck, I was supposed to get groceries. Fuck. You know, yeah, like she got shot.
Can I still get the groceries?
Is Fry's still open? And they're like,
whoa. Whoa, chill.
Sound effects. Chill.
Damn, Lou, chill, bro. That fucking lady who got shot.
Come on, dude. Come on. Don't make it real. Don't make it real. Don't play a funny clip. Make it real. But years before, I went to go get a gallon of milk so I could eat cereal. And I was stoned. And I just watched Conan because Comedy Central used to run Conan's in the afternoon. And they did the in the year 2000. Yeah. I was walking into the store and I said that to myself. I go, in the year. And this giant Vato just goes, what are you laughing at, white boy?
Oh, no.
And I look over and he's holding like a baby that's like, it looks like a raisin. Like, that's how new it is.
Oh, I thought you were just being racist.
No, it looked like it had all the brand new pink folds. It was just like a brand new baby. And he's like a little peanut. He just hands it to his wife and he's like, what's up? And I'm like walking, I'm maybe a half an aisle in front of him. And he's like, what's so funny, white boy? And he's just walking around the store, and I get the milk. I don't stop once. Small talk Dan, never stop moving your feet. Grab the milk, get to the front of the – and he's like behind – I look back. And he's like
– oh, no.
Coming down the giant fucking dude. I get in line. A woman gets behind me, and I'm like, oh, thank God. This guy just gets behind the woman and starts talking shit. And I'm like, it's weird that you would respect the line. but still talk shit. But I was just so in the zone of like, just like automatic, like just pay for it. And he's like, what's up? Just kept saying that. Got the milk, fucking ran. Second I paid for that shit, ran out the store. Got my car like, fuck, go. Don't know if he came out. Just took off. Fucking was so like, right as I got on Ina Road, I was like,
oh my God.
Very high. I was smoking resin. I didn't have any money. So I was resin high. You know, resin high, how you're just like super intense. It's like a really intense, and then you get sleepy.
Dude, I got high, and I went and saw. I was begging my friends to go see Cloverfield.
Yeah.
I was pretty excited about it. No one else was. But
I was so excited for it because they did it's back when I worked at K-Rock. They did like a sneak trailer.
Yeah.
And they wouldn't say what it was. And the trailer was like the Statue of Liberty head screeching down the street.
Oh, yeah.
And I was like, J.J. Abrams. I was like, this is going to be.
So I got high before that. That was the only way they'd go is if I smoked a blunt with them before.
A blunt, too.
I'm not a fucking good weed guy.
And so a blunt.
Things were not going great for me.
That's like someone that doesn't drink doing shots.
Yeah.
If you don't smoke weed and you smoke a blunt, you're fucking done.
So we go into the dollar store to try to buy some cheap sweet treats for the movie.
Okay.
Good plan so far. Things are going well. We get in there. There's a insane man in a trench coat.
Dollar store so really probably pulls
I was
in
high.
Some-
I was high and looking at like old computer games. And I was like, holy shit, fucking Age of Empires. Yeah. Yes, dude, this is sick.
Spear of Destiny.
Crazy man in these like blind guy glasses walks up and just goes, bibbity, bibbity, bibbity. And I was like, oh, no. And he goes, bibbity, 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 bibbity. He just kept saying bibbity, bibbity.
Wait, was the jacket closed?
No, it was an open gray like trench coat.
And then he had sunglasses on.
And black like wraparound like blind guy sunglasses.
Like, okay, blind guy or like Bret the Hitman Hart?
Not cool. Not Hitman Hart.
He's
a man with an
blind
eye
man.
Problem.
Yeah. Bibbity, bibbity, bibbity.
He just said that.
Is he old?
Yeah. And then I started laughing because I was high as fuck. And I was like, there's nothing I can do to handle this.
Yeah.
So I go get in line and he just turns and faces me and just starts saying it louder.
Bibbity, bibbity, bibbity.
He's talking to me while I'm in line. And I'm just laughing. I'm like, holy shit, I gotta get the fuck out of here. So I'm laughing. This lady in front of me turns around, and she's like, yeah, like she turned around like kind of smiling. So I was smiling back. I was like,
stoned.
I was like, hey.
Yeah, you look for an indicator.
She turned to look at me. I figured she was going to commiserate that, hey, that crazy guy.
Hey, crazy guy's yelling out, bibbity, bibbity, bibbity.
She was like, there's something really uncomfortable about somebody laughing behind you while you're in line.
What?
And I was like, what? I was like, oh my God. This is crazy.
I'm the bad guy?
And then she got to the front door and she turned around and goes, especially when he's fat.
Whoa! Whoa, she tossed a grenade before she ran out?
I was like, what the fuck is happening?
Being stoned and then just getting insulted for trying to deal with the situation.
The fucking crazy guy was still doing it. He's doing it.
Homo says what? And you go, what? She goes, bibbity, bibbity. Got it. And then she looks at the other guy and goes, bibbity, bibbity. Bibbity, bibbity, Bob.
Yeah, so
this is their guy? That's their mascot?
And then we didn't see Cloverfield.
What?
Then we didn't even see it.
That movie made me sick in the theaters.
Then I went and I saw it again. Well, I saw it for the first time, second attempt, got high again, and forgot it was a monster movie.
What?
Because the opening scene's a party.
Yeah, they're all at a party.
It's real fucking high.
And then shit
the monster
goes bad.
Came, and I was like, oh no.
Dude, that's a great high, where you're like, what a fun movie. This is like, can't hardly wait.
It's like, oh, she's leaving town.
And you go, oh, they're so hot. Oh my God, there's a monster.
There's a monster now attacking the city.
What is this monster? I had an old winter jacket from Burlington Coat Factory that was like this big brown puffy jacket, and I was so nauseous that I was holding the sleeve of it watching Cloverfield, and I go, if I throw up, I'm throwing up in the sleeve of this jacket, and I tied off the arm.
Stupid plan.
It's such a dumb plan.
Why don't you go to the bathroom?
Because I didn't know why I was sick. I thought it was it's like I got sick watching the Blair Witch Project, and I got sick watching Cloverfield. I can't deal with that camera shit.
Me too.
Really?
Yep.
You get
not like I didn't get sick, but that same type of the car sickness feeling.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And I'm just watching it and I'm like, fuck. I'm just like, but as the movie's going on, I'm like tying a tourniquet out of my fucking sleeve.
Like, I'm not going to miss this movie.
It was a K-Rock premiere. So they're like, I really wanted to see it.
So all the bigwigs were there.
Yeah. Like my boss, the music director is like sitting behind me and I'm like, and I'm breathing, and I'm trying not to watch the movie because it's obviously the motion's making me sick. So I'm like, I'm just breathing hard. Like,
damn, dude, if you would have fucking thrown up into your jacket at the fucking, like, man, that guy must have been really spooked out. It's a really spooky movie.
You know, dude, Soder does not like monsters. I go, it scares me. I don't like that a monster crawled out of the ocean and it's mean.
I'm scared right now.
It's so mean. Oh, God. I'm so scared that the monster's so mean. TJ Miller's the voice. Get it. That was Blair Witch. I got sick and I didn't know why. My friends made fun of me for being scared.
I would have.
Yeah, and then I blame
it. I make fun of you for being sick during a movie.
It sucks. It's I don't know what it is. It's the
no. It's that shaky camera thing. There's another movie. The one of the Paranormal Activities. That's like the Mexican Saints one. Is that same kind of shaky camera?
The Mexican Saints one. There's a Mexican Paranormal Activity.
Yeah, what? It's what? Yeah,
they go,
yeah.
The baby, my.
Oh no, it's some fucking fantismo.
Yeah, it's just
bruja. It's fucking bruja. That wish.
Yeah, I was in the
found
sneak
footage.
Yeah, that was the sneak preview where they were just like the Statue of Liberty. This movie, I watched Cloverfield. For some reason, I watched it at home on my TV. Fine, loved it. Enjoyed the movie.
I think any found footage movie actually does suck. Kind of fucking annoys me.
Yeah, well, they always do the same tricks.
They got to do this. It's like, dude, no one would be holding the camera.
Yeah,
so we got to stop
this.
Yeah, we got to stop pretending that.
Yeah, no one's going to keep holding on when their friends start dying or when something jumps out of their stomach.
Yeah.
I don't care what's out there.
I don't care what's out there.
I got to go find my girlfriend.
I need to go out there. My girlfriend. I'm moving to Japan.
Yeah, dude, if there was a monster, I'd be single immediately. Yeah.
I'd be like, later, I'm going to find me a lady in Osaka.
As soon as the monster's there, I'm just like, well, I'm single now.
You're hiding downstairs in the subway, and you just meet a girl, and you go, hey, I'm Shane.
Hey, yeah, I'm actually single.
Hey, I just lost my girlfriend back on 48th
Street. Oh, my whole
Street.
Family, yeah, that monster just ate him.
Yeah, it's crazy. We were in this hotel, and they crushed it. Hi, Shane, how are you?
Grab whatever you want, baby girl.
Nice to meet you. So, do you live in New York, or are you just running from the monster?
Oh, I found a new fucking baby girl today.
Who's your
on Instagram?
Bring it up.
Oh, fuck, I forget her name.
If you don't know the lore of Bonfire, Shane brought Jay and I, Sierra Sky, and Roman Palumbo. And Roman threw our... God, she still hasn't unblocked me.
She's never going to unblock
Damn.
You.
Roman!
Roman will not unblock you.
Why?
You're lucky the Bonfire still has access.
You're right.
What about... Is she wearing Macho Man glasses in that?
Yeah. Gonna make it rip through some denim. Uh-huh.
Wow.
Look at that.
She seems to have changed.
Don't fuck yourself.
This isn't my baby anymore,
dude. That's like
She's
baby.
Better. Look at her in the co-op. White sneaks.
Good.
Bikini.
God, bro.
Yowzers. Hi. I just want to throw money at that.
she's like a Cloverfield monster. I'm single immediately if she's in the room. Like, what, my wife? My wife is dead.
You push her downstairs? The monster got my wife. And she's like,
she looked at me like, what, I'm single?
What's your name? You go, I'm single. I claim nothing to no one. You are my queen.
Her,
Who's a new baby girl?
I gotta find it because the new baby girl's Roman is fucking hilarious.
Come on, let's get it.
There's a new Roman, except this guy's fucking sitting at like less than 2,000 followers.
Yes,
he's the type of Roman we need. Bro.
Yes, he's new Roman.
He is, and he's like a jacked dude. He's fucking.
Look, I mean, is he more cut? Because
no,
I'm a cut
dude,
guy. Look at this. Look at that bath.
Let's just agree, no one's Roman.
That's basically
no one's Roman.
Me and Mike are gonna recreate that when I come back from Scotland. Becky and Anne are gonna recreate that picture. With me in the bathtub. Becky on and his fucking crusty Judd Apatow movie mustache.
No, my friend Jared. What up, dupes? My friend Jared sent me this chick today. Her name's Emily. No, fuck.
Where is
fuck,
she?
It's not her.
What's her name?
Oh, hold on.
Find it.
If you click on like a hot chick's Instagram, there's a suggested for you.
Yeah.
And then there's like, there's a
million. That's how you got there? But did you follow her?
No, I didn't follow her. God, there's a million of these chicks, and it's so funny.
Yeah, it's a cash grab, dude. This is like the fucking gold rush for hot girls right now. You, Black Lou's nodding his head. You know, working that Dallas Cowboys
Ladies
fan page.
100%.
That's Ladies right. and gentlemen, yeah. We got them.
Yeah.
So her name's Nikki Guile.
Spell it. Like
she's
Guile,
at,
like,
dude, she's sitting at 1.5 mil
like
followers.
Like Street Fighter?
Bro.
Like Street Fighter
Nikki,
Guile?
G-U-I-L-E? G-I-L-E.
Oh. Oh, she's almost Gillis.
Almost. Not yet.
Shane, spell it one more time.
Nikki, N-I-C-K-Y, G-I-L-E. But more importantly,
Nikki
her.
Nikki Guile?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Her bae, dude.
Wait. Go down. She looks like she. Okay. Sierra Sky.
Sierra Sky's, dude. Sierra Sky in a fucking.
This yeah. guy's and she's the perfect. She's Andrew Luck. I mean, I don't know. Look at this girl.
This is her bae.
Yeah, yes. Mine, dude, get the bae.
Okay.
What a handsome man.
He's her world, but what's his name?
My world.
His
click
name?
On it. Is he tagged? He's got to be tagged.
No, he is tagged.
He's tagged in the photo. Look, go click on that person shit right there on the bottom.
Fucking pussy.
All right, Jacob, I do not need you riling this up.
Wait, what?
Oh, they live on the East Coast, too.
Mm-hmm. Uh-oh.
Oh, we could get him on.
This is my man.
This is your guy, Venice, Brandon.
So. No, Venice.
Photography, travel, no, Venice. Active lifestyle, fashion and music, everything I love. Me and this guy are definitely going to get along.
Dude, this guy's awesome. Like, go back to his interests. Go back to his interests. Fashion. He's downtown Mykonos.
Fashion, music, music festivals.
Yes, Venice. Photography, too.
Man.
Mykonos. Go down. Let's see some of these. We'll tweet this out at the bonfire. We got a new Roman in Sierra.
This is
courtesy of Shane Gillis.
Good, poor man's Roman, dude. This is a good guy.
You ever call him poor man again, he'll snap your fucking neck.
Nah, bro. Until he gets more followers than me, he can fucking chill.
I mean, they're not even like matching correctly.
Yeah, they are. They're target Roman and Sierra.
Yeah, really novice.
Roman and Sierra would spit at them.
They're not even on the same
wouldn't.
Level.
I bet you Roman would offer him a drink.
I mean, Roman would obviously be chill.
He'd be like, pull up.
I mean,
this is my girl Sierra.
This guy's thick, so Roman might be into it.
Yeah.
Roman might be like, yeah, that's fucking cool. You're working out and shit all the time.
Yeah, you're fucking big, bro.
Yo, is your girlfriend hot as fuck? Yeah. I also work out.
He goes, I work out and I look at my girlfriend who's hot as fuck. Life is pretty sweet.
It's lit.
It is lit.
It's fucking lit, dude.
He goes, the guy, this Brandon guy goes, also, I got a red cam.
What?
the red.
Hold on, scroll down a little. He has one picture of him taking pictures of someone's ass, probably his girlfriend's. No, yeah. Keep going. Instagram, there it is. Instagram boyfriend life.
Yeah. Oh, at least he's fucking. What does it say? What does the caption say? Does he admit it?
Like, this life chose me.
I didn't chose this life. This life chose me. You know what? Good for him. He's putting himself up there. I like him. Brandon
yeah, like
just
him
scored
too.
Points.
I like him too. I mean, that's why I brought him to. I laid him at your table, dude.
Yeah. I just thought you knew another saucy couple, so you wanted to bring
it
along.
No. I just like this couple. I like this guy.
Yeah, these people, both couples to me seem like they don't eat a lot of bread.
No.
It seems like it's all keto.
Not a lot of bread, dude.
All keto.
This guy, I don't know. He gets after it.
He drinks? You watching his Insta story?
I didn't get into
it. Because Roman parties.
This is one.
I mean, I would love to do a newlyweds game with Sierra and Roman versus these two. If we were in L.A., Christine, if we do a live show at like the Comedy Store.
Mm-hmm. That would be fun.
Get both of these couples?
Yeah.
Come on. Let's make it happen. Let's do it in January, February.
Yeah.
Let's go out to LA.
Whoa. You guys are going to fucking chill with Sierra?
You're coming too.
Yeah, come on, guys.
Dummy.
Well,
you think we're going to go to LA?
I got to be honest with you. I will murder them if I see them.
No, you won't. You'll start barking at them, though.
If I see her, I'll be like, you fucking bitch.
I fucking love you.
Look what you did.
Look what you do to me.
Now look what you did.
They go, why is that big guy in a baby Bjorn? And I go, because of this? Chain back. You're like, you know where they probably take care of business is on the sheets in the
sheets.
Yeah, and not sheets. The
because I know they take care of their business.
No, they don't. We're a Wawa family, but the folks at Boll & Branch are feeling really flattered right now. Ever since their family business became the industry leader with the world's most comfortable sheets. They've seen a lot of imitators make similar promises, even repeating words from their ads, but no one can duplicate the quality of Boll & Branch. That cotton starts out soft and gets softer and softer over time. $1,000 sheets for just a couple $100, and the only sheets loved by hundreds of thousands of Americans, Big J. Okerson, and three U.S. presidents. You show me those sheets somewhere else. That's why 97% of customers surveyed said they sleep better on Boll & Branch, but you won't find them in a big box store because they're not there. Starting this summer, get 100 nights to try them. Shipping's always free. Right now, you get $50 off your first set of sheets at BollandBranch.com. Promo code Bonfire. Spelled B-O-L-L and Branch.com. Promo code Bonfire for $50 off. BollandBranch.com. Promo code Bonfire.
Yeah, what's a promo code?
Hey, dude, it's how you get money cheaper stuff. We're going to take our first break. Come back, talk some fucking Area 51.
Whoa,
we're
spooky.
Storming it.
That's spooky stuff.
Campers, we're going to do it. No, we're not. Please don't.
Yeah, please don't.
You're going to get killed.
I love the government.
You do? Tiger style?
Yes.
We'll be right back.
Do you think your Wu-Tang sword can defeat me?
I'm going to eat chips.
Live for the win and the gold.
New Big Crit.
Yeah.
Picked by your boy, the Bull of Bulls, the Dog of Dogs, Shane Gillis. Guest hosting for Big J while he is in Montreal. This is The Bonfire. Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I'm Dan Soder. This is my baby boy. Jay's such a good friend. He called and asked what weed I want from the dispensary. What a good friend.
What'd you say?
I said I wanted pre-rolls, but they don't do that in Canada because they don't party as hard as we do. He didn't know. So I was just like, I'm going to get a quarter, a hybrid. Well, nothing too high, nothing too low.
That's what I would get. I would get a quarter or a hybrid.
Yeah? I didn't think you smoked weed.
I don't know what that is.
Well, it's a nice balance.
Hell yeah.
Yeah. It's Matt and Shane's Secret Podcast. Go download it. I wanted to talk to you about this because it's something that I listened. You said you watched both the documentary and listened to the Joe Rogan.
I did not listen.
You just saw the documentary.
I just watched the documentary.
I started watching the documentary, the Bob Lazar. That's what I'm talking about.
Bob Lazar, yeah.
Bob Lazar, L-A-Z-A-R, a scientist that worked in New Mexico at several different locations. Joe Rogan Experience interview with him is unbelievable. It's great. It's like a minute 50.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Whoa.
No, he has some fucking, he's got some, Rogan's obviously a crazy intelligent dude, but he's got really good questions for him that I was like, fuck, I wouldn't have thought to ask him that. It's a great interview. It's a really good interview. There's a documentary on, of course. There's a documentary on Netflix called Bob Lazar.
Yeah.
What's it called? It's called like Bob Lazar.
Yeah, Area 51. If you just type in Area 51.
Bob Lazar, Freaky Friday.
Yeah.
It's called like Saucers and Other Things. Well, here's the thing. I wanted to talk about Area 51 with you, but we have a much more important matter at hand, and that is the guest that is joining us. You know him from The Bennington Show because he is Ron Bennington.
Whoa.
The radio god.
Whoa.
Welcome to The Bonfire.
This is exciting. This is, I guess,
the setup after Big J's plane goes down. This is what the bonfire.
Yeah, when he gets La Bamba,
like.
when Big J La Bamba's.
Yeah,
this is how we replace it. This is the sad new arrangement. We just have a candle in Jay's old chair.
I don't even like joking about this type of thing.
Yeah, we're just joking.
It's if okay. you no joke spookies. About it, then it won't happen.
Thank
That's
you,
That's what the Irish believe.
That's
look
why
how
Shane...
well they've turned out.
whoa.
Shane's bro. Blown away by mysticism. Oh, he's chill, like, don't say that. don't do it. White gypsy curse. This Friday, 4 p.m., possibly one of the coolest things that I've ever seen in my life, but one of my favorite moments of Skankfest. Unmasked. Ron Bennington and Dave Attell.
Yes.
The
yes.
Dave Attell Unmasked. How long did you try to get an Unmasked with Attell?
Well, as long as I've known Christine. That's how far yeah. back it went. Christine's yeah? been the one working on this.
How long
for
ago?
The longest period.
Would you
of time.
Say over 5 years?
About that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it wasn't like I was working on it or there was, it was, I asked Ron if he would want to do that when yeah. we first started working together, and I brought it up to Dave, and Jay talked about it with him, and it was always like, yeah I'd love to, and then it just finally he said yes and gave me a date, and I literally jumped up and down in the middle of my street.
Did you feel like he was avoiding
exciting.
It?
No, I mean, I get it. I don't like to do interviews myself.
Yeah.
Attell's
not that guy. Attell's
no.
not a sit-down interview guy. I don't
no,
think there
he
is
isn't.
One long one out there.
You know what was really funny is, like, when we came off stage, that's when I saw how many comics were just standing there. And I'm like, oh, thank God I didn't know that.
If you would
At
have,
the time, it would have been really weird.
If someone would have taken a picture, it would have looked like a horror movie because there was just a bunch of us staring at a wall just down at the ground. We were yeah. all staring at the same place, like down at the wall, just listening. I was like yeah. next to Dave Smith and a couple other people. And we were just, it was, I didn't know he was, Attell wears a very funny thing. I don't want to give up the joke, but he comes out rocking a hat of some sort.
Yes.
I didn't know he had it on because I didn't see him until he came off stage. And I was like, Attell was wearing that the whole time?
Yeah.
And they're like, yeah, fuck
well,
yeah, he was.
Yeah, he kind of broke it out in the middle. But the thing about him is, like, Jay grabbed me and he goes, dude, I've been on 9-hour car trips with him and never heard these
yeah.
stories before.
Yeah, Jay, you know, I know Attell through Jay. Mm. And Jay was like, yeah, there's some questions that I didn't know. I don't know Attell's answers for, like, who
are you?
Yeah, who are you?
Yeah.
But
isn't,
like,
that what you love about him?
Who inspired you?
Yeah.
Like, where did you come? Because when he said, you know, the one thing I'll give up from the interview is he said he looked up to a guy like Colin Quinn. For some reason in my mind, Colin and Dave are always like equals. Like,
right.
It's like, so you never think of a time where Dave Attell's looking up to Colin Quinn. Like,
well,
oh, yeah.
you know, Colin kind of broke young with,
remote,
you know, a couple
yeah.
of, with Remote Control. And then, of course, he went to. So you never kind of, in your mind, you never catch up. You know
yeah.
how that is.
Yeah. But it was great. I mean, he talks about some other of his influences, and it was great. He's just fucking Dave Attell. He's just like the best, one of the greatest.
I love that he brought
time.
Up Rich Jenny. It's just somebody who had a lot of craft.
I didn't
know?
Want to give that away.
Yeah.
I didn't realize how influenced Attell was by Richard Jenny. And
yeah.
then you talk to the guys that are like Attell's age, and they're like, oh, Richard Jenny was a fucking beast. And I
yeah.
think in our generation, the younger guys, I think we kind of overlook him.
You David Brenner him.
Yes.
That's what you do. Like, you go, oh, he worked in this style.
Yeah.
So, and people are going to do it with Gaffigan one day.
Yeah.
So,
yeah, that's how they shit on him.
Yeah.
They go, he talked about food.
Right, yeah.
And that's his,
but when
one
you're
of the
there,
most brilliant comedians
yeah.
of all time. He said
when,
food too
but
much.
But when you're there in the moment,
yeah.
you know what I mean? Jenny was, like you said, he was a beast. And he used to do my show in Florida.
Yeah.
And then when I came up here, O&A were kind of busting his balls a lot. And I'm like, it's fucking, you know.
Richard Jenny.
It's Richard Jenny. And then Jenny called me and goes, hey, could you talk to the guy? I go, dude, it's never going to work out the way you want.
Yeah.
I got their gimmick. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It doesn't work with, okay, now it's okay.
Yeah.
You
they
know
don't
what I mean?
They don't do a,
yeah.
oh, now everything's cool.
But he was a lot more sensitive than like Voss or whatever. He's a very sensitive guy.
Yeah. I
remember one time. I saw him kind of sad spiral, right? He
yeah.
was doing my show, and we were sitting there, and we're having fun, and then a phoner from Richard Lewis came in. And I go, Richard, you know, Rich Jenny's here with us. And he just kind of blew it off like he had no idea who he was.
Ooh,
so then, like, for the next
hurts.
Year, you know, I would see Jenny. He was like, how's your buddy Richard Lewis doing? I heard he's fucking drinking a lot. And I heard he, and I'm like, hey, man, you know
yeah,
what I mean?
Yeah, whoa. Like, oh, so not, he kind of took it out on you.
No, he was just like, he was trying to always save face over this yeah. little, you know, these things happen.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah,
I mean, these things people happen. Don't,
sometimes, I mean, that's got, all comics have that thing where like someone does that to you and you're like,
right.
so what the fuck? You just don't think I'm a fucking comic?
Yeah,
right.
I usually just call Dan right away.
Yeah, call
so far, every single comic I've met in New York, yeah. there's been the first time I met him and then I called Dan the next day and I'm like, is fucking Zach Amico a fucking dickhead?
Yeah, I'm like, yeah. No, no, no. Whatever I'm like, no, 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 yeah. no, no, no. I try to explain to Shane, I'm like, no, no, you're just being way too much of a comic right now.
Right.
Because, you know, Shane's coming from Philly where he was like the king and then you come up here and people are like, I don't know who you are. And you're like, I fucking hate you.
Yeah, yeah.
I will say this, though. Who else has come into New York and has lit it up the way Shane has?
No, not a lot of people.
Yeah.
Not a lot
of
people.
I mean, the fact that you chased Tim Dillon out of town?
Yeah.
That's
crazy. Everyone talks about that.
That's fucking unbelievable.
Yeah, Tim Dillon's on the run.
There's going to be one big fat gay dude. And that's me, dude. I'm here. Oh, by the way, New York, you guys don't know this yet. I suck dick.
Yeah.
So, that's can thing. You guys start hiring me?
Yeah. None of us really believe it about Tim, though. That's yeah, the no, thing.
I was like,
go, are you?
I thought it was just a genius marketing strategy.
I thought so, too, until the 4th of July party. I saw him taking a fucking picture of a watermelon. He was holding up. He was holding up a piece of fruit over the skyline, and I was standing next to him. I was like, "Oh yeah, forget you're fucking gay."
Yeah.
He, every once in a while, he does something gay, and I'm like, "Oh yeah." Fuck.
I took him on a string of shows where we did like Boston, New England, and then we ended up in Vermont at the Vermont Comedy Club. And we're driving through Burlington, Vermont. It's a college campus, and there's like a bunch of these shirtless dudes in backpacks. And Tim just goes, "Well, hello." And I was like, the only time it was the only time where like I've seen Tim be gay. Where I was like, "Oh yeah, dude, that's your shit." Get in there. It's just a bunch of shirtless hunks in Burlington. And
he's
like,
got that old dirty accent. He should be a construction worker talking about sniz.
Yeah. Yes, that's exactly right. His whole life has been thrown off.
Young boys.
Yeah, look at all these hard-shouldered fellas. And you're like, why is their voice so smoky?
The funny thing, Fez tried to tell us for years that he wasn't gay.
Yeah, dude, your announcement. Big J, when Big J and I became friends, one of the clips he always made me listen to was Fez saying he was coming out on your show. Where he's like, I'm gay. And then he's just silent. And Ron just doesn't say anything. It's one of my favorite, one of my favorite radio moments of all time. Because Jay was like, dude, you got to listen to this. He's like, I know you know. Because I listened to you guys when you were on at K-Rock, Free FM.
Yeah.
I was doing the weekend shifts. I was doing overnights. So we had access to all the fucking, you could go back in the log and like listen to shit. And I'd listen to ONA and run. I got caught a couple times with like, you should be running the board. And I was like, what's up? But Jay, I remember being in his car in front of the comic strip. And he's like, he had satellite. He's like, you got to listen to this. This is the episode. We're going to smoke a joint until it happens. And that was one of my favorite moments where he's like, okay, I'm gay. And then, it was like, and then nothing.
Right.
And then like the music.
I was offended.
Yeah. Ron was like, okay. It was fucking. Yeah, but Tim Dillon is a guy where you're like, he's so aggressive and big, you're like, if you were straight, you would be a problem.
Right, yeah.
If you were a straight guy, you would have a fucking hell of a time now.
Yeah, and that's why he probably goes around saying that he's gay.
Yeah, he goes, I'm real gay. Also, your girlfriend's tits are magnificent.
Yeah.
Oh, you're gay. You can squeeze them.
Yeah. He goes, oh, can I just finger pop your girl right here?
I didn't think he was gay at all until he showed that picture of himself when he was young.
Oh,
he was with those,
with the dancing one?
With the dancing thing. And it was, I mean, I laughed for 2 days. I'm going, this would have been buried so far in my soul.
Dude.
They would never see it.
In the 1950s, right now, Tim is married at his age.
Yeah.
He's married with two boys and a girl. And that picture is like from the 20s where he was like, you didn't know he was a twinkle dancer. That's like hidden in a fucking chest in someone's
back
attic.
Back then, they didn't know what gay was.
That's what I'm saying.
So
that's why
he
was
like,
just big.
He was a great dancer.
He could dance and perform, and he just didn't chase it.
And then he would get hammered at nights and just keep driving past the stone wall real slow. Hey, fella, you need a ride?
Yeah, he just goes, you know, there's some cute boys down at the park getting weird. And then he just smashes a guy's head and goes to prison for 4 years.
He would have to do that.
I got one of those. I got one of those in my buried deep. I got me and my friends in fourth grade at the talent show did the Village People. Did YMCA as a choreographed dance.
Oh, man, I'll tell you.
And then I was dressed as a fucking construction worker. And my
did you have
sisters,
the mustache?
I have older sisters, and they were like, you and all your friends are gay. And I was like, what? And they're like, the Village People were gay. I was like, I thought this was about just having fun at the Y.
I didn't get that joke in Wayne's World. in Wayne's World, is it Wayne's World 1 or Wayne's World 2, where they go in and they're in the gay club as YMCA, and he's like, do it, Miss Thing, do it! And that's when I got it, and I was like, oh, fucking all right.
Village people are gay?
Yeah, I was like,
I had
no idea.
I thought they were just action figures.
Yeah, I just thought they get, there it is. There's the Tim Gunn version.
God, it's unbelievable.
Come on.
Holy fuck.
It's either a gay man or a sex addict.
Yeah.
You know, either like a hardcore sex addict where he's like, I need it all the time. I got to pay for it. I need it for free.
This is from the Jeffrey Epstein variety show that ran in the early 80s.
He goes, put down your Cornish game hen. And we have some entertainment. Tim and the girls are going to sing a song. Now, Tim and the girls will be available for island pleasures. Dude, I think we should start making up other comics that went to Epstein's Island.
Yeah.
Because you were saying.
I told you about one.
Yeah.
I told you about one on the list.
McCusker, he has a podcast called Matt and Shane's Secret Podcast, and his co-host found like on a, was it on like a.
Something probably on like a 4chan or Reddit or it's one of these. It was a fucking website.
It was a list of people that went to Epstein's Island. Michelle Wolf.
Really?
She didn't go to his island.
Did you verify that, bro?
Yeah, I know Michelle.
You sure she didn't go to his island? I don't know.
Cult, like a rich cult.
Oh, yeah. No. What if she goes, what if I say that on the phone? Like, dude, you know what Shane said? You go to, and she goes,
when did he say that?
Yeah. I go, what?
He goes, did he say it on the air?
I go, I said it on the air.
I didn't say it on the air. I wouldn't have said that on the air.
She goes like this. She goes,
you're in big trouble. You need to leave the city. They're coming for you.
Yeah, dude, that shit, Epstein's Island, they're going to find a bunch of stuff.
Dude, I was invited to two parties at Epstein's house. Both of them were comics that were invited to hang out with Woody Allen.
Oh.
And I'm like,
wait, Woody Allen was there?
Yeah. Woody's a buddy.
I don't think, yeah. They have a shared love of something. Yeah.
How did he break that to one another?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You just had a bar drink and just be like, yeah, damn.
Jeffrey, if I could bring something up, nothing's better than small children.
God damn it. I was hoping you'd say that. Yeah. I got a fucking island.
He goes, birds of a feather.
Yeah.
Come on down to the Bahamas.
We're going to get a hold of Clinton. The three of us are going to get away for a long weekend.
Bill goes, is Woody in? All right. The time to party.
Yeah, did you see that Trump party with Epstein? That was
That came out today, right?
Yeah, it came out today, and it was like 92, and I'm watching it. First of all, it looks like the deep fake or whatever. It doesn't quite look right, but I thought none of us would want to have a video of us from 92.
You know what I mean?
Everyone was whacked the fuck out.
You know what I noticed about the 90s?
Yeah.
People didn't know how to be filmed.
Right.
Like now, people with phones, when someone puts a phone up, you kind of know how to do it. In the 90s, if there was like film, they'd just be like, ugh.
Everybody would stiff.
Like just wave.
When does it start? Yeah. Is it going? Is it going now?
Okay. Hi. They always talk to the future. Hi. Yeah. Cilia, it's me. It's your uncle. Hi. I hope you do well.
Well, everyone died at 40 then. So, yeah.
But now everyone pulls out a camera and you just immediately go to fuck me mode. Is that it? That's on right there? So the tape shows Trump and Epstein discussing women in 92.
Yeah, this is Mar-a-Lago, when this video takes place.
When the island names...
if I just see Trump, I laugh.
Yeah, he's funny, man.
He really cracks me
Shane,
up.
Yeah. Shane calls him Big Sassy Daddy.
He's the big daddy.
Epstein... I bet there's women that find Epstein still attractive, even though it's coming out he's a pedophile.
I think he looks better now than he did back in the 90s. I thought he looked a little fucking nerdy.
He looked nerdy, and now he's got that salted gray, I had a bunch of children as sexual partners look.
Done a little jail time, I mean, you know.
He's gonna go,
there's the party, and there's young Trump with heavy brows. Young Epstein. Look how fucking... Trump is starting to dance a little there.
Oh, Marla Maples.
And you never see that.
Yeah.
And watch him with this girl in the green.
All these baby girls, dude.
Look, he's pulling her in, slapping that ass.
That's my president,
dude.
Now, look at him here. He's just digging it a little bit. He's doing a stroll.
I've never seen that guy happy.
That's the old stroll.
He did a fucking... This is so great, Jeffrey. I don't care where these girls are from. Oh, it's such fucking 90s, too.
Great.
He's got ruffled hair like he was really partying.
Yeah. They should just run this as a campaign ad.
Look at him pull that chick in. I love that.
He's like, come here, bitch.
Yeah.
That small in the back on a lacy top.
But you never see him dancing. And look at him there. He's just in the middle of the room and kind of moving with it.
Yeah. It'd be funny to get all these women together and recreate this scene now in 2019.
Well, even that Epstein was like, oh, what is it, 28?
He goes, Don, these ladies are a little old, huh? Yeah.
They all look a little old for what I was picturing.
Yeah.
I mean, 90s baby girls.
90s baby G's?
These are the baby girls back then.
Oh,
his
man.
His overbite is my favorite thing.
The lip bite where he's like, ooh.
He's a little Don Jr. looking even.
Yeah, he's just got all those ladies flocking him.
Yeah.
Ron, I'm glad you came in because we started talking about something downstairs that I really wanted to talk about.
Okay.
Which is the infestation of iguanas in Florida.
Yeah, they're everywhere.
You lived in Florida for a long time.
Yeah.
Did you ever live there when they just gave an open call to kill?
Well, I'd kill them anyway.
You would? What was your method?
Normally, I would either kick them to
death.
Go
to the pet shop and strangle them?
Yeah. Just play them out.
Darn.
I mean, they're fucking baby dinosaurs, be honest about it. But I don't even like the little lizards that have that condom throat. You ever see that?
They blow it out.
Oh, they're
disgusting. It's like a frog-based kind of.
And you would walk out of your house, and they would be looking at you and backing up.
And you would kill them.
Look, motherfucker, you know?
But just to show.
They're not playing this, yeah.
So there, I was watching a bunch of videos online of people killing them, and there's like dudes with sandals just like smacking them on the head. And then one guy's just taking them and like whipping them into a building.
But there's so many iguanas because everybody got them to eat cockroaches and palmetto bugs.
Is that what it was?
Yeah, so then they fucking took over.
So they just
Florida is just barely out of the Stone Age.
Yeah.
You know?
These people are just using guns. This is Cayman Islands. So they're hunting him with a fucking sniper rifle with
a
silencer.
That's a Rouvray right there. Look at him, all whacked out, having the time of his life.
They go, listen.
With the Indian mangoes.
Yeah, they brought him back. This is his return to war.
Yeah.
They go, the fight's not done. And he goes, I've been waiting for you to tell me
that. It's Chris Kyle, bro.
Yeah. Where do you need me? They go, iguanas. It's a real problem.
Can we win this time?
Yeah.
Of course, he can kill anything that changes colors. Mm-hmm. He can eat things that make a billy goat puke.
I'm excited when I see the lizards down in Florida.
844
the little guys? Them?
Yeah.
Real 844 Comedy 9, if you live in Florida and you have to kill some of these iguanas, because I feel like it would get annoying to the point. I don't want to kill an iguana, but if I got annoyed to a point, I think I could take a couple out.
Yeah, if you're in Florida, get to your nearest gas station payphone and give us a call. Fucking trash.
Or if you could ask the officer that is coming out of this radio on his desk.
Yeah. And do the meth after your call, because you get really,
I don't need a speedy
really
story.
Chatty.
Oh, they're kissing.
Yeah, you'll like the tiny lizards more if when you approach them, you say out loud, you go, oh shit, cops. And then they fucking scurry away.
That is a fun thing.
Next time you walk down the sidewalk and you see like a squirrel or a fucking tiny lizard, just go, oh shit, cops.
they run like
run
cops.
Into a bush.
Those little lizards, they're the most paranoid reptiles we have.
Yeah.
I mean, you never see.
They give squirrels a run for their money on their paranoia. And squirrels are, I would say, the most paranoid animal. Would you say lizard more than?
Yeah, I mean, a New York squirrel gets comfortable. You know what I mean? Just like the pigeons.
New York pigeons are just like,
they're too much.
When did you move here?
Yeah.
You go, my father's from Queens. You're not even from New York. You moved from Denver in 2007? Get the fuck out of here.
Oh, my God.
Look at that guy. Giant lizard makes home in Florida's family backyard. Well
that's not an iguana.
How do you kill that thing, though?
That's a fucking Komodo dragon.
That's the one that if it bites you, it's got meaty teeth that end up killing you.
That's a Gila monster.
Yeah.
Gila monster from the island of Inda Japan, a Gila monster. They have those all over the place. Komodo dragon.
These are a big
I would have to do that. That's how I would kill my iguanas, with a samurai sword. And I'd go, you have brought a dishonor to my front lawn of a townhouse. Sink! Dan's out there doing his, I do a whole dance before. Dun, dun, dun. Fucking tea. Jasmine tea.
I don't think you have it in you, bro.
I don't think I do. But I think if I got annoyed to a point, I could smash like
two. Have you
ever
killed an animal in your life?
You don't want to kill a lizard, bro.
I'm not a killer, man.
Oh.
Have you?
Killed everything that walks or crawls.
God, you're a badass.
Everything that walks or
just
crawls.
Just a certifiable fucking badass. Shane, have you killed anything? Like hunting?
Yeah, literally. You kill some fucking small animals. Small game.
Wait, hold on, though. Is this small game, or is this young Shane putting a cat in an oil barrel that's on fire?
No,
and he goes,
No.
He goes, hell yeah, I want to see the kitty dance.
I always felt bad any time. And then when I was younger, we used to go out and like fucking bother like groundhogs, shoot them.
Pellet
that was always sad.
We'd shoot at prairie dogs or pellet guns, but I don't think
you
I ever.
Prairie dogs out there?
Yeah,
you shot prairie dogs?
Yeah, there's a ton of them out there.
I'm a fucking fan of prairie dogs.
Colorado. Yeah, just made this field behind my house. I didn't hit connect. I never connected.
They were my favorite animals.
They just pop up?
Yeah, I'd go to the Hershey Zoo and look at the groundhogs.
And then
there was a flood, and the groundhogs, the enclosure flooded, and all the groundhogs
died.
The draw at the Hershey Zoo is the groundhogs.
Yeah, they go, guys.
They're lined up. Yeah. What time are they feeding the groundhogs?
They go, guys, we lost chocolate and Reese's.
Yeah.
The groundhogs so drowned. they drowned, guys. Yeah. Crunch Bar's dead. Did his name him after the Reese's candy? Look at these
you
guys.
You gotta love these guys.
Yeah.
Same thing, Jay doesn't like raccoons either.
He hates raccoons.
How do you not like these guys?
Raccoons are great.
Raccoons are hilarious.
They are.
Groundhogs are great. Although when you corner a groundhog, they get real fucking mean.
Yeah, can you find a groundhog attack? Can you go find a prairie dog attack? Because I'd like to see that.
A prairie dog attack somebody?
I don't know. I
prairie
see.
Dogs are adorable, dude. They wouldn't do that. Groundhogs will get you.
Otters are nice.
Otters are sweet.
Yeah, I love this.
Otters are the best.
Otters might be the best
otters
animals.
Invented the water slide.
It
there
did.
Was no fucking water slide before otters.
That is true. You got to give. Wait, hold on. Groundhog attacks man. Look at that guy's face. We'll tweet
like
it out
a
at
fucking
the
grizzly bear
at
dude.
The bonfire. SXM. He's trying to bite through the glass. It's got to be such a funny thing to watch. Can't fucking let me in. I'll fuck your shit up. I was like, oh man, that is terrifying. I want that picture though. Just that picture of like if you did a sketch of that picture trying to bite, you know, just a fucking angry. Look at that right there.
Dude, what if comics just start bringing an animal to the stage like 1980 wrestlers?
I have said so many times that this studio would be so much better with a giant rabbit in it.
Yeah.
One of those huge fucking rabbits.
Right.
Jay is adamantly against it. And I want.
He's afraid of big rabbits.
I want a big. You know the ones. Yeah. You know the ones you hold up and their feet are fucking. You just hold it like this, like up under its fucking
what is
arms.
Out west, it's the jackalope or some.
Yeah,
bullshit
it's like a
thing.
Big. There it is. Yeah. Look at something like that. Look at that guy.
That is
four
insane.
Feet. That's a 4 foot rabbit. How cool would that be? Yeah. Come on, you guys wouldn't feel better about being at work. Black Lou's on board. Witzke hates it.
I'm gonna text.
Look at him.
Bobby Kelly to get two for the Creeps with Kids tour. I think that'll be the draw.
That would be.
During the meet and greet, we'll bring out giant rabbits with us.
Come on. If you named one dude.
Yeah.
Bring out dude. And he goes, not dude, you got to feed dude carrots.
By the way, I want to just point something out. Keith Robinson is telling people that this is the Crips with Kids tour. That's bullshit.
He goes, rep your set, rep your kid. Rep your set, rep your kid. 268. He goes, fuck all pie rules. So
he took
it is,
my soft candy.
Yeah. Keith Robinson. I don't like it. The gang affiliated. It bugs me. They're out there saying that the Crips are good. I'm a blood comic. Fuck crabs. I'm about that blood life. Pyro. Keith Robinson, Pyro.
I'm into this Creep. Rabbit thing. I didn't think I was going to like rabbits.
You did. They're great.
Not a rabbit guy.
By the way, go get tickets for Creeps with Kids. Unbelievable comedy tour with Ron Bennington, Rich Voss, Jim Florentine, and Bobby Kelly. They're on a tour in September?
Yes, in September.
In September. And, of course, October. Fucking Unmasked with Dave Attell this Friday, 4 p.m.
It's going to be great. It's going to be great.
One of the only reasons I've ever wanted to activate my Sirius account. I've worked here for 4 years.
Mm-hmm.
I miss Jay, and when I'm in Scotland for Edinburgh, I'm going to listen to the show.
Yeah.
But mostly I'm doing it this week so I can listen to Unmasked.
Well, how long are you going to be in Scotland?
Whole month.
Wow.
I go Montreal. Are you going up to Montreal?
Yeah, I'm going to Montreal, but then I'm going to Comedy Center, the Comedy Center up there. I'm doing an Unmasked. This is mind-blowing. Smothers Brothers.
What?
The Smothers Brothers, yeah.
You're going to do a fucking... That is unbelievable.
Yeah, it's unbelievable.
That's comedy history. I mean, that's like the... Outside of Mel Brooks, I would say...
Have you ever met Mel?
No, I'm a massive fan.
Yeah.
He's one of the only people I think on this earth that I like him, Josh Homme. There's a couple people that I just wouldn't be able to be cool around.
Right.
I'd just be like, hey, Mel Brooks is so important.
I didn't think you were being cool around me and Shane.
Yeah. I lose it when I see Shane.
This is cool, Dan.
This is cool, Dan.
Yelling, let's get a rabbit, everybody.
Yeah. Dude, that's how I chill.
Like a 4-year-old.
I just love rabbits.
Can we
chill.
Please get a rabbit?
Yeah. That can't be their website.
Dude, these guys were on TV in Trouble 50 years ago.
Yeah.
50 years ago, they were basically
the people they
getting PC'd. They were doing anti-war jokes and civil rights jokes and just, you know, they were kind of doing like...
So they were doing gay shit back then.
Yes, yeah.
Now. Now what's gay? Now.
Right.
They were actually new to it.
They were Tim Dillon.
Back when it was cool.
Yeah, back when it was cool.
How did you get that? How did you set that? That's fucking crazy.
The New York Comedy Center did it up. And you got to go up and see that thing.
That's in Buffalo, right?
Yeah. Well, it's outside of Buffalo in a place called Jamestown.
I've heard it's unbelievable.
Yeah, it's just... Un-fucking-believable.
Someone said if you like comedy, I was talking to a comic, I think in Cleveland, they said that they went twice, both times over 2 hours.
Right.
They just walked around.
Well, you could just sit and look at people's notes, which to me is always the best stuff. Wow. You know, you get Carlin's notes and then, you know, just what he was working on. You see it, you know.
Dude, that's unbelievable.
Lenny Bruce's fucking coat, the one that he was arrested in, is there. And there's this really amazing thing where they kind of do blue comedy from the 50s. You have to go downstairs. So it was like Pig Meat Martin and all these like guys from the Chitlin circuit that were working so fucking rough in like 1956. Like dropping the fucking C-bomb.
Really?
In 1956.
That's just blowing people's fucking minds.
Yeah.
That's awesome. The comedy, the National Comedy Center, which is up upstate New York outside of Buffalo. So if you're in that area, go check that out. Cause that's, someone said something that it was after I worked Helium where they're like, oh, did you go to the Comedy Center? And I was like, nah, I didn't go out there. And they're like, you fucking missed it. The place is awesome.
Remind me next year. Well, you know, make sure you get up and get involved with these people. They're a lot of fun, man.
So you're going to do an Unmasked with the Smothers Brothers.
I'm going to do an Unmasked with the Smothers Brothers. I'm doing a panel on Robin Williams with, Louis Black and David Steinberg, who was the manager of Williams all those years. And then, Louis Black is in very big with him. Kelly Carlin has donated all the stuff.
So awesome.
That they have. There's a lot of Gary Shandling stuff from the Larry Sanders show. I mean, you just walk around and you can't believe it. But like I said, there's something about seeing, like, I remember... Mitch Hedberg's wife said, oh, this is his notebooks, right? And you would go through his notebooks and just see, like, this great joke. And then, you know, what time his flight was leaving. You know what I mean? Like, it's just wasn't treating it like it was precious.
Yeah, he's like, I don't know, I got to write it down. It was like a movie to watch.
Right,
he's like, go back and watch Tremors 2.
But you're all
like,
that stuff.
You the fucking duck bread joke after watching Tremors 2?
But that's exactly right. Like, after somebody's gone, you go, oh, my God, this stuff is, has value to it.
Yeah, like
at the time, you know.
Oh, dude, I bet if you gave someone like a joke book 20 years ago and you're like, fuck this, whatever. Yeah, it becomes valuable. And like Robin Williams, you know, he's probably all his stuff that they got now. Like when you die, you probably just, your whole family's got to be like, here you go, Comedy Center. Because no one else wants comics notes.
It's
the family's like, I don't want your fucking joke notebook.
It's really, really true. Because I'm doing something on Ernie Kovacs there.
Yeah.
And I met his stepson. But it's true, the families after people died. And, Apatow just did this with Gary Shandling. You go, look, I want people in the future to know what happened here.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean? We do that with writers. We even do it with rock and roll people. But comedy, because fucking comedians are such contrarians, they won't act like anything is great.
Yeah.
You know?
No, we won't give it up for each other. Yeah. And then when they die, you go like, yeah, he's pretty good.
Yeah.
Like, kind of fucking hack.
Yeah, right. You know, I don't know. I heard someone else do that joke, but I guess if you like it, it's pretty cool.
Or they'll just tell the grossest story ever about the guy getting drunk and shitting himself.
Yeah.
You're like, really?
When I,
you know.
When I first met David Costable on Billions, who plays Wags, he was like, we're just getting to know each other. And he's like, so you're a comedian? And I'm like, yeah. And he's like, the second meanest group to each other in entertainment. And I went, what? And he goes, you guys are so mean to each other, but you're not meaner than Broadway dancers. He's like, Broadway dancers will trip each other, push each other downstairs. He's like, comedians will shit on each other the second they leave the room.
Right.
I'm like, yeah, you know comics. I was like, you've hung out with some comedians.
If you remember the movie Striptease.
Yeah, of course.
Pushed the fucking Gina Gershon down the steps.
I hate to tell you this, the Showgirls.
Oh, Showgirls, you're right.
Just as someone that jerked off to a lot of softcore stuff like that at
that
time.
I went to the Demi Moore movie by mistake.
Because in my world, striptease was the hardcore version. I mean, Showgirls was the hardcore version of striptease. Striptease was just Demi Moore in underwear, which was awesome.
You must have looked at them fucking in a pool going, does it have to be this aggressive?
Yeah, I thought it was a whirlwind. You had to hold on.
Shark attack.
Yeah, I thought you had to hold the girl and then she just fucking. Can you bring the fuck scene up from Showgirls where she's Elizabeth Berkley?
Do that anyway.
I'll try to find the fuck scene.
Find the foxy when she's in the pool. And this guy looks like, you know, we had a small beef with John Fugelsang.
Yeah.
And this guy looks so much the main guy.
I see that now.
Yeah. I was like, oh, man. The guy from Showgirls hates us.
Have you and John worked it out?
You know, I think we just stopped talking.
Live and let live.
Live and let live kind of deal. Yeah. It's also funny. Oh, there's the scene. And her nails.
Yeah.
This was Jesse Spano. For young people who don't remember, Showgirls is this terrible stripper movie.
Damn, Jesse Spano fucking. I remember watching Saved by the Bell, not thinking too much of her.
Not me neither.
And boy, she turned on the jets.
Breakaway speed.
I remember seeing her in Any Given Sunday, and I was into it.
Yeah. That's all. Where she plays the hooker.
Saw her fucking tits in there.
Yeah. I don't know why you say it so aggressively.
Because I loved it.
Yeah.
Everyone loved Tiffany Amber, so nobody even really thought about her.
Yeah, Tiffany Amber Thiessen was Kelly Kapowski.
And then she ran to the straw, right?
I love it.
Yeah.
But this scene, my friend Mike McDaniel and I, it was like when we got the tape of Showgirls, I was spending the night at his house.
That's a stunt. That's a stunt ass.
This is like a gay cult classic.
Yeah.
Is it really?
Yeah.
Well,
it's like a mommy
dearest
type.
Hey, let's pour some champagne on your face, baby.
You just wasted it.
Yeah.
Also, it's like you got to clean that pool.
Yeah.
You just put a lot of champagne, but he
thinking about the pool.
But I remember, me thinking about the chlorine levels.
You ever fuck in a pool?
No, not good.
It's not great.
Not good.
Water gets in there with the your dong.
We were just saying that. It's like
it's a real miserable experience, in my opinion.
The whole point is to use a little Vaseline.
Yeah,
really?
Ooh. Yeah, go in with a little Vaseline.
Smart.
I've never had the foresight going into a pool fuck.
I've been carrying Vaseline on my hips since 1981.
What are you, a trip pitcher?
I go,
Ron Bennington, two things. He can fuck in a pool and throw a slider.
He's out in a public pool with a fucking Vaseline next to him.
I get the Jeffrey Epstein Vaseline. It's unbelievable.
I go, dude, first off, if you're down in the count to Bennington, he's going to smoke you.
Yeah.
Also, if you want to fuck him in a pool, pretty convenient.
Can happen.
Honestly, Epstein should open a line of fucking Vaseline.
What? Yeah. Just jerk off Vaseline?
He's a lot of young kids.
Oh, my God. Yeah, he's probably all the crimes he's committed. But I always thought
he's going to walk, by the way. He's rich.
Of course he is.
He's a billionaire. Dude, this was like the closest to porn for me when I was in eighth grade. And I was like, look at that.
Now watch her get going.
Look at
that
water.
Fucks
Who fucks? No one fucks like this. Also, if she stared at me like that, I'd be like, stop it, psycho. Yeah.
Remember the lap dance scene? The lap dance scene's super aggressive.
Whoa. Yeah, look at that. She's like, I'm moving. I'm grooving.
I'm saying this.
That's hilarious.
I've had friends broke, and this is how shit like that happens, because you can't trust her to be a top.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
You're hurting. You're going to hurt me. You're going to come down too hard, and it's going to hurt me.
There's responsibility in being a top, and she's fucking giving it away.
Also, in real life, she says some weird shit, like, I'm a dolphin. I'm a dolphin. I'm a dolphin. And he goes, I poured out all that champagne for you. Dude, this movie, it's so funny to think that the guy that I watched this movie with is now the offensive coordinator of the 49ers. it's like weird to think of where life goes. Like in eighth grade,
Whoa, I didn't know this was going on.
Yeah. You're wasting your time on Any Given Sunday. This fucking is the shit
right
here.
Damn, dude.
Yeah.
Gina Gersh. I mean, come on.
She's just like emulating what she's doing.
Yeah, she's like a batter on deck.
She's doing that again. That's her move. So that's like her go-to move.
Yeah. And this fucking idiot. Again.
She make him come in his pants?
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely. Dude. I might come in mine right now.
you're gonna might come in your pants too.
Dude, that's such a funny way though of like that's your super skill as a stripper where you go, watch her. She'll make your man come in his pants.
He's got pop. He's sitting down, he's gonna pop.
we have to go home now,
so thank you.
Thanks for ruining these. I was gonna go out to a nice steak dinner downstairs.
Isn't it like men that frequent strip clubs? Isn't that like the point? Or
you wear
no?
like gym shorts and or like sweatpants.
Isn't it like they're no like getting undies. Off without cheating?
We're talking about a no undies Sunday with Shane.
I'm glad you see that as not cheating. It's really progressive.
No, I mean like that's how they think of it. My idea. Yeah. My ideas are all over the place.
By the way, I forgot how terse this scene was where she's just like, give me my money for making your boyfriend come in his
pants.
Yeah,
she was really fucking chesting up with her.
She's like, good job, dude.
Yeah.
It's like, well,
even though you're gay, no one's going to know it now.
Yeah. She goes, you got some soggy sweats on. What if he was wearing basketball shorts? They made him crusty. They made him like really seedy. And he's just like, yeah, yeah. Oh, man. We got to do a, you know what? We always say there's like companion pieces we should do for movies. Mm-hmm. We definitely should do Showgirls.
For sure.
And watch
that. It's unbelievable.
Yeah.
Damn. You know, I ran into Gina Gershon out in Vegas the night I was there that the fucking Holyfield's ear was bit off.
What? June 24th, 1997?
Yeah, we were all leaving
yeah.
at the same time because shit got really fucking crazy in the casino.
I mean, oh, really?
Yeah, I mean, really bad.
You never think about that. When you watch something crazy like Holyfield Tyson and he bites his ear off and there's like our favorite, one of my favorite clips of all time is Jim Lampley on HBO after the Riddick Bowe, the riot. Jay and I have the drop where he's like, I got a 16-year-old daughter now.
16-year-old daughter in here somewhere.
He's like, he just let a riot happen. And he, by the way, plugs all the shows. And then finally, 15 minutes later, he's like, it was 12 minutes. Did we check? It was 12 minutes after the thing broke.
Into a riot?
Like, yeah, he goes, I got a 16-year-old daughter now there somewhere. You're like, you didn't care? But you never think about that. When shit goes down in the ring, what it really affects is everyone around.
Everybody went fucking crazy. Yeah. I was in the press box. Pulled the fucking guy over some seats. Told me to sit down. I was out of my mind. You know, I don't know whether because the major fights are really gone.
Yeah.
But at the time when you're at the fucking championship fight, you feel like you're going to throw up. You're so excited.
Holyfield Tyson. Yeah.
Fucking believe it. I can't believe it.
And by the way, two legendary heavyweights that didn't... Was this the second time that they fought that he headbutted? Because the first time it ended clean with Holyfield winning on
points, right? Yeah, and Tyson was, you know, crazy right from the get-go the next time.
Yeah, the next time he was like, he just can't... He kept saying he headbutted him. That's why he...
Yeah, it was bullshit.
But the bite down Miles Lane, was that the ref?
Mills Lane.
Yeah, Mills Lane. Just remember him. He got famous off that bite. Yeah.
Right.
Like that launched his career. Everyone knew who Mills Lane was, right?
Celebrity
Most of the people did not know it was a bite. We didn't know why.
So you didn't know what happened.
No, and here's the thing. It was there was like 150 big celebrities there, you know. Yeah. Eddie Murphy, you know, just went on
probably like real mid-90s celebrities like
Trump.
Yeah.
Mark Paul Gosselaar.
Trump daddy.
And then there was serious fucking West Coast gangsters everywhere, right?
Mm-hmm.
And they were all dressed and like bad tuxes and shit. And when that went down, they just went in the casinos. They were knocking over fucking tables. You just hear shit popping off. Everybody was being forced outside. It was fucking nuts.
Damn.
It was like being
MGM,
on the
MGM, right?
Yeah. It was like being on the Titanic.
Like, everyone's just flocking to the doors.
Fezzy was with me and he was yelling, Ronnie, my pants are too tight. I can't run it. Don't leave me. He was fucking screaming. And then we all get out and like
while you were running, you're like, he's definitely gay.
I'm gonna have to wait years for this, but I know.
The fucking second I met him, I was like, hey, we gotta bring the gay kid back. He's amazing.
Little light in the loafers.
Tight pants.
We were out, there was like thousands of people out on the strip, right? And this fucking car comes by. And a fucking young black kid is just fucking hanging out. You just see this thing that he's holding like this. And people are like screaming. And then you just see him pulling it up. And it was like a 90s video camera. And everybody thought it was an Uzi. They were just going to lay the place
really?
Out. So we were like, we couldn't even get back. We had rooms in the fucking casino. We couldn't get back in for hours, right? We get in. We're like, oh, man, I'm going to fucking turn on the TV and see what happened. No mention. Nothing was mentioned. And there were people that were just grabbing chips and everything, and they fucking do not put that out there.
That shit just went crazy.
Yeah, and then they just go looking for people and take care of it themselves.
Well, I mean, dude, you, there's that's never what's up with casinos.
Yeah, that's no. There's never a casino where like, hey, we lost control.
Yeah,
you know what I mean.
Casino's like, don't worry. Yeah. 2 hours later, there's gonna be some people walking differently.
Yeah,
he goes, I got some guys that are gonna be missing some fingers, if you know what I mean.
And
but
in
Gina
the meantime,
Gina Gershon was just
standing like with her fucking it was fucking like I just ran right into her face, and all I thought was like, Gina fucking Gershon.
So
and we just locked eyes, and she was just like, is the psycho going to kill me?
You know what I mean? Because
that's
I'm
what everybody
die.
Was thinking. Yeah. You know?
She's my top five of all time.
Oh, she's unbelievable. I had her on the show.
Gina Gershon?
Yeah.
Oh, my God, yes. Dude, she is like the sexiest lady I thought.
Which one was she? Was she the one sitting there watching?
Yeah.
Yeah, she was the one watching.
Bring up Gina Gershon. Yeah, bring up some fucking prime Gina Gershon for young Shane
Bound.
Gillis.
Bound. The movie Bound. Oh. Lesbian film Bound.
Oh, I mean, yeah. Sounds sick. What happened? Yeah.
Did they
march?
They marched.
Yeah.
They marched and they shut down a comedy show. That's bad.
Real hot lesbian flick.
You go, hey, your use of certain pronouns is not cool, bro. Me and my partner, Chris, we're here to tell you got to be silent. What's up with young Gina? Stop looking at it. Christine, quit hogging all the Gershon. Quit hiding all the Gershon. Yeah, dude, this is again, right? Welcome to Softcore Wednesday with Dan Soder. Big J's out. It's not hardcore.
Oh, you like a fucking powerful mommy.
Yeah, he
does. You got like a fucking stud.
What?
She's a stud, dude.
Dude, she's hot as shit. Look at her. Her and Jennifer Tilly.
I'm not a poet.
Oh, it's all out of sync.
Oh, yeah.
Bring up a... Oh, come on.
Jennifer Tilly, crazy hot.
Crazy hot. And good at poker. She's bride of Chucky. She's just really the total package.
Scene with her, the cuck scene with her and Michael Madsen in The Getaway.
Wait, yeah. There's a fucking cuck scene back then?
Yeah.
Would you think they invented it during the 2016 election?
I thought incest and cuck got invented like the last like 3 years.
No.
Game of Thrones and the Trump campaign?
Been around since the ancient Romans.
Come on, that's their thing.
Look at these two.
Look at these two. Love. Bring up pictures of young Gina Gershon.
How young?
I mean, not Epstein. We're not going Epstein, dude.
See if you can get her a brownie custom.
We're trying to get her out of Epstein Island.
What's she doing with her hand?
Oh, what? She's making her leg quiver. Is that her tickle spot? Like my mom's dog? It's that spot, does her leg vibrate?
Damn, she fingers well. I've never fingered someone and had that reaction.
Well, you got to fucking get some tips from Jennifer Tilly. But I remember this coming out, and you were like, what?
Yeah.
Look at that. Is that really her body?
Yeah, it's Gina Gershon right there.
Let's wait for it, because I forgot how awesome it's getting. Boobage! Boob on boob.
Major boobage.
Major boobage. Do you want to wash my daughter's awesome rocking tits? Yeah, dude. Young Gina Gershon.
Yeah, I don't even think I could watch this movie on a plane.
No
I
way.
Go,
no.
On a plane?
We're in the fucking danger zone. We're in the danger zone.
Yeah, you just look at the kid and go, this is fucking badass, right?
Don't tell your fucking parents,
believe that,
dude.
Right?
Yeah, you go, you tell your parents you're a dork. I won't
fucking
do nothing.
You're a narc, dude.
You're a narc.
I see some cool shit.
I'll tell you, you play this cool, I'll get you a Biscoff. I'll grab you a Biscoff cookie when they come around.
My friend jerked off on an airplane when he was in fifth grade.
What?
He didn't get up. He told me he jerked off on an airplane, and I figured he went to the bathroom. But he stayed in his seat.
He stayed in his seat.
Just a 10-year-old jacking like,
there's some fucking hungover like businessman like
right.
Wakes up kid. From a kid shaking. Just
he's
like,
all, hey, mister.
Jesus Christ.
He goes, hey, mister, I'm scared. He's going to pop one out.
You know,
you can't say anything if you're the guy.
My producer, the legendary Chris Stanley, jerked off on a bus.
In the bathroom.
Coming back from, I think, Hershey, Pennsylvania, as a matter of fact.
Hey.
Jerked off next to his mom.
What?
Whoa.
Yeah.
That's legendary.
Lou just gave it.
Oh, no.
Like, Lou was all like, I knew it. I fucking knew it.
Wait. The post-cum feeling of that has to be one of the worst things in the world.
Yeah.
The post-cum.
Hey, how old was he?
Well, he was old enough to buy tickets for his mom. He like,
bought the tickets?
Yeah, I think it was to see Seinfeld.
Come on.
Yeah.
What? That's so funny. He goes, what's the deal with jerking off in a bus when your mom's sleeping next to you? You're horny. Just wait to come. Why can't you wait to come?
Holy fuck. I was thinking he was a little kid.
No. He was a full grown man.
This is an adult. he made this choice.
He was just back from Vietnam. He'd seen some real shit.
He goes, "You don't even know, Mom. Shut your eyes. I got to get some of the demons out. I got to get my anger juice
Christopher, what
on.
Are you doing?
Look at your baby boy.
Look at your baby in the middle. Dead. All the cum is dead." He just gets the scene on Rambo in the rooftop.
All right, let's go to the cuck scene. Jennifer Tilly, Michael Madsen. This is, in my opinion, one of the classic fucking scene. Yeah, so there he is tied up like a fucking cuck that he is.
Oh, this is nightmarish.
Yeah, but watch. That's his chick who she just, this is his kidnapper that she had just met today. This launched the cuck movement in America.
I didn't know Michael Madsen was the forefather of cucking.
Yeah.
He's the forefather
cuck. He fucking like couldn't get a hard on unless
the
guy
in the rest
was
of the
crying.
Movie? Does he kill both of them, hopefully?
Gets a little sad after this. I'm not going to lie to you.
It gets worse?
You want to know? Because it's a spoiler alert.
Spoiler alert. Everyone, if you don't want to watch this, is Michael Madsen, Jennifer Tilly movie.
So the guy, the next day, they just find hanging. And fucking Michael Madsen just throws the cat on his chest and takes a piss next to him.
Yes.
He doesn't fucking care about anything.
Yeah.
That's great.
That's why he was the king of the early 90s.
So he Michael got cucked and then fucking hung a guy?
Cucked and died.
No, yeah. He cucked a guy and the guy hung himself.
Yeah. Because what is he going to do? Fucking live after that?
Yeah.
I thought the guy getting cucked hung him.
What are you doing?
It's a sick move.
You supporting the cucks?
Yeah.
I feel horrible for this
guy. You're
the
fucking bull, dude.
No,
you're the bull.
Hell yeah. True.
You're in New York now. Leave that cuck shit behind.
No. I'm saying, so wait.
Your cuck love stays in Pennsylvania.
Hold on. I'm not a cuck, dude.
Your cuck love.
What I'm saying is, what happened in this scene? Was that
he was kidnapped by Michael Madsen.
Yeah,
and then Michael Madsen fucked his wife while he's tied up.
And that's his wife right there?
Yeah.
But like fucked his wife like totally willingly.
Right.
Yeah. And the wife, it was consensual.
Because she was going to go from that fucking idiot to Michael Madsen.
Who's just a maniac.
Yeah, half the men in America would have fucked Michael Madsen after Reservoir Dogs.
Oh my God, are you that dancing? Come on, he takes an ear? He could take this ear. And by ear, I mean my cum.
Oh, no,
I
Dan.
Sorry.
Yeah, I'm
sorry.
You went with
that's
that.
Inappropriate. Oh. I'm super inappropriate. Unmasked this Friday, 4 p.m.
What a setup.
Ron Bennington, you're the
cucked
fucking
best.
Cucked
by David Tell.
If you want to hear Ron Bennington get cucked on his own show by a hot Dave Attell action, seriously, check out Unmasked, one of my fucking the best interviews I've ever heard. Friday, 4 p.m. And again, go see Creeps with Kids. It's Ron, Florentine, Bobby, Voss. They're going to be touring.
Legends.
You are a true legend, Ron Bennington, and we love you.
Thank
for coming
you
by.
So much for having me, guys. And
we'll see Harrisburg. You guys are going
to
be in Harrisburg.
Yeah,
we're coming to Harrisburg.
My hometown, man.
Why don't you swing by for that? Talk about your parents.
I definitely will.
Yeah.
Do it.
You guys are doing.
Do it. Shane, man sticking out his hand
I'm putting
for
it out there.
Thank you very much.
Nothing but respect for this kid, am I right?
How fucking fun.
He's unbelievable.
Fucking, what a joy to watch this.
Easily rookie of the year.
Yeah.
And he's on the All Star team, on the rookie All Star team.
Stop.
Yeah. It is. So
I got,
anyone,
I got 10 minutes.
Anyone, you put a bullseye on his back.
Yeah.
If you're coming up, you go after Shane.
I'm going to tell you this. I knew Brian Regan back in the 80s when he had 18 minutes. And I'm like, that's the funniest fucking guy in America.
Yeah.
You know, there's 30 people watching, but you know when you come along one of those generation guys, you're fucking really good, dude.
Damn.
You're really, really good.
There it is. Shane's going to be on cloud 90.
I'm going to cry.
Yeah, we love you, Ron Bennington.
Hey, stay off that pipe. Stay away from that crack.
Yeah. Stay away from the drink.
See you guys. Thank
we
you
love you, Ron.
Much.
We're going to take a break. We'll be right back. It is The Bonfire, which will be live in Montreal next week. Maybe Ron will stop by then, too.
Big Crit,
shouting. Big Crit, new album out now. You know, it's a favorite of Shane and I on the road.
Listen to fucking Mount Olympus by Big Crit if you want to get your fucking juices flowing.
Or Saturday.
Ooh.
Or the song Saturday.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Oh.
Ooh. Ooh. I've been listening to Big Crit and instead of Lisa Ann, a bag of cum.
I just do a Ziploc bag.
Ooh. I be coming in bags and sending them to porn stars and then giving them dolls
I
made
go to
hair.
Comic conventions.
Ooh.
Ooh. My mom drops me off.
Ooh. My mom drops me off in a minivan and then I go get a boner and take care of it in the bathroom.
My mom ghost rides the whip.
Ghost ride the whip. My mom's growing out so ponytail, I think about growing one.
So I can meet porn stars.
Ooh. Oh. My favorite porn star is Sarah J.
I know most of their middle names.
I know the real government names. Ooh. I be looking up porn stars in Yellow Pages and finding out where they live. Ooh.
I search by male porn stars' names.
I love creepy E40.
I love their work.
Yeah. Ooh, ooh. I be finding government names of porn stars and harassing them when they're at their regular jobs. Ooh. It is the Bonfire Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. Big J. Okerson up in Montreal for the Nasty Show tonight through the 27th. Go to BigJComedy.com for more details. And then all next week. Actually, just Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. I lied to you. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, we're going to be broadcasting live from Just for Laughs in Montreal. We're going to be at the Soprano Room C at the Doubletree, Tuesday, July 23rd through Thursday, 6 to 8 p.m., doing live bonfires before I head to the Highlands of Scotland for a month. If you want tickets to go see me at the Fringe Festival, go to dansoder.com. It's right there. I'll be at the Dairy Room at the Underbelly July 31st through August 26th. Come watch me do an hour. Was going to do like some fucking sissy old one-man show, but then Ari Shaffir told me to beat the brakes off and just fucking go for the throat. So I'm going for jokes, bud.
Nice.
So you come see me in Fringe, you just seen an hour of motherfucking jokes.
Damn.
Kids coming.
I forgot to give you guys my dates.
Okay, Matt and Shane's Secret Podcast. Go download that right now. One of the best podcasts.
August 22nd, I'll be at the Harrisburg Comedy Zone. Then the 23rd and 24th, I'll be at the DC Draft House.
Big buddy. Coming back to headline.
Then the next weekend. I think it's like the 28th.
Don't do the Allah joke.
Allah joke's killing. I'm going to do it as soon as I'm done saying this. The 28th through 31st of August, I'll be at Cap City in Austin.
In Austin.
Austin, Texas.
In August, it's hot.
Yeah, but it's hot down there?
It's hot.
In Texas?
Hot in Texas. Austin, Texas. Very hot. 28th through the 31st. But go make sure ShaneGillis.com.
Yeah.
What?
I'm the only one who fucking... I run the website, so it's garbage.
So do I.
Is it
ShaneMGillis.com? ShaneMGillis.com.
When he gave your website wrong?
Because I forget the name of it.
ShaneMGillis.com.
You reminded me.
You don't update it?
I don't.
Talk to Becky.
It's
what
hard
are you doing?
To update because I forget my fucking GoDaddy password.
Oh, God damn it.
So the dates are just wrong.
Someone out there, please get Shane Gillis a fucking working website. ShaneMGillis.com.
I think Shane Gillis is still available, so...
Don't get Shane Gillis, then fucking make Shane a website so this idiot can have somewhere to go promote his show.
Yeah, I forget.
That's not bad.
Pictures are nice.
Very artsy.
Gay.
The bio's real gay. But there it is. Look at all that. You're going to be...
Those are wrong dates. I think those dates are now wrong.
Oh, my God.
822 Harrisburg Comedy Zone.
Those are correct.
823.
Draft House. 828-30 Wards Cap City. Then your Helium Indy, 920-921.
Yeah, but it's the they gave me the tiny boy room.
That's fine. Whatever.
Yeah, true.
Come through and smash it.
Are the dates right on the website?
I think the dates are right, but my manager does my calendar, so it's always, she adds like a day or two for like travel. So then I don't know which days I'm actually performing. I don't know. The whole thing's ridiculous.
Well, anyways. Shane,
the Allah joke, dude. The Allah joke was sick.
In the draft house. That was like,
it was
a good joke, but I remember, I remember a whole meal of talking you out of the hole.
The joke is, hey, do you guys like impressions?
Yeah.
This is Allah on 9/10 calling Osama bin Laden.
Yeah.
And it's like, hey, Osama, it's me, Allah. You know how I fucking hate towers?
Yeah.
Could you guys fucking, oh my God, you're doing it. You guys are crazy.
Oh, yeah. Shane just did he does the point of Allah as they're carrying out the 9/11 attacks. And I've seen it. Crush
it, it's
and then
rare.
I've seen it not do
that thing,
well.
That thing go, that's about a 10% success rate.
DC
on that.
Draft House was a hilarious miss in a way that Shane just got off stage because it's only a 2-man show.
So I think
Shane,
I closed with it.
You did because he just wrote it that week. And Shane brings me on stage and he goes, "I shouldn't have done that." He goes, "I'm sorry, I shouldn't have done that." That was exactly what he said. He goes, "I'm sorry, I shouldn't have done that."
And right before I did it. Like, right before I got on stage, I was like, I'm doing the fucking Allah joke. And he was like, don't do it.
Yeah.
Don't.
I was like, dude, it was like kind of a light crowd. I'm like, dude, don't do it.
Don't do it. I was like, I'm going to close.
It was like Saturday early show. I'm like, don't.
I'm going to close with this new Allah impression.
Yeah, he's like, oh, God, you guys are blowing up the towers. It's so sick.
I did it at Helium.
Yeah.
And a fucking Muslim dude in the back. I was like, do you guys like impressions? This is Allah. And this guy just stood, this very Muslim dude in the back was like, do not do it.
During the joke.
And I was like, what?
And then you're the dog looking back with like, don't run outside. And I was like,
exactly. And I was like, well, now I'm definitely going to do it. Now I have to do it. He got fucking carried out. Yeah.
He goes, please do not. It's the one like, sacred thing in my life.
Do
right
not
now.
Do it. Do not. And I was like, I paused for a second. And then a bunch of people started to be like, do it.
What if you're on the, what if you're on the ISIS hit list?
I fucking wish they would, dude. I wish they'd try to tread on
They're
me.
They're too scared. They Can know. I tell you something? I heard you're on the don't do not tread on me list.
ISIS has a don't tread list.
ISIS goes. There's a young bull out of Harrisburg,
me,
Pennsylvania.
Alex Jones.
Yeah.
Trump daddy.
Yeah. Big sassy daddy.
McCoskey, obviously.
Rogan.
Rogan. All the elite fucking ballers.
All the elite boys. All the elite BOYZs.
McCosker and Joe Rogies.
Rogies.
Dude. The yeah. But everybody, they were like, do it, do the joke, and I was like, well, the joke fucking sucks. This is a ton of
and
pressure.
Then you're like, this is such a silly joke to do,
and then I did it, and everyone was like, "That sucked." Yeah. I was like, "Yeah, I know it sucked."
Meanwhile, that guy's fighting three bouncers. He's like, "I will destroy this man for bringing up Allah in a negative stereotype."
I've done some like fucking rough shows in like North Philly, like black rooms where I've been like kind of worried about maybe getting my ass kicked after a show. This was the first time I was like, "That guy." There's an off chance he comes in and kills me with a sword.
Yeah. I don't think sword, buddy. I think you see that fucking AR-15. You hear that banana clip drop.
Yeah. Where is the fat pig?
Yeah. You have a man that I can only call to be a fat boy that I will destroy.
That young baby man.
You have a child who is a big child. And he talks about Allah in a way.
Yeah, that's a fucking... That's scary because that's that one of those jokes where you're like, I know those motherfuckers believe that shit enough. God's the one thing to be like, yeah, I'll blow myself up for God. And if you're like, hey, you guys want to hear me do a joke about God? And like, do not think about my God like that.
He literally just goes, do not. Yeah. It's like, what?
Do not. It's so funny to think of a guy just eating mozzarella sticks in the basement of Italy. He goes, man, dating is weird. And you're like,
oh, this
you
is fun.
Do you guys like impressions? Do you like,
yeah, I do.
This guy's, what is he going with this?
Maybe an Arnold Schwarzenegger?
This seems like a risky bit to roll out. Like, what? Do not.
Do not.
Do not. He puts down the mozzarella stick. Do not. My fingers are very greasy from the cheese. Well, the government, look at this for a segue, government telling people,
do not
go to Area 51. 1.5 million people have signed up on this Facebook group to storm Area 51. You fucking idiots. Whoa. No one's going to do it. It's a joke, obviously.
It's an internet joke.
I hope
people try.
Storm a fucking base.
If I were one of those guys that worked at Area 51 and I was itching for some action, I'd kind of be excited for this.
Come on, hit these.
I'd be like Nomar Garcia Parra with my fucking batting gloves. I'd be like, first one pops over the horizon,
Killer
I'm fucking
reference.
Murking them.
Nomar.
Just fucking... And then they're like, Dan, you're on the sniper tower. I'm like, I know.
Yeah, I've been here.
I got up at 8.
As soon as I saw that meme, I've been up here.
He's like, I've been fucking,
you pissed your pants. You're just laying there. Just like, please.
30 degrees north. You got him.
We lost 1.5 million people that thought like an internet joke was real, we'd be better off.
Oh, absolutely. It's definitely thinning the herd a little bit.
Yeah.
Bring this news. This is ABC News talking about it.
Coming up, are aliens real? A bunch of fucking internet idiots think so.
They are real, by the way. Shout out to aliens.
Aliens are definitely real, bro.
Thank you for the technology. Thank you for the simulation. Thank you for believing.
You're going simulation theory?
I just like to cover all my bases.
Yeah, I fucks heavy with aliens, dude.
Dude, aliens are the best.
Me and them.
I'm a big head.
Do you think they're just so evolved that they don't feel they need to destroy us?
No, we're like mosquitoes to them.
Christine, they could be operating on, you know, totally different dimensions than us. They could be so small we can't even fucking see them.
Also,
there's just so much going on here.
Sound like a real asshole.
Yeah,
you know,
Christine,
really
if you're
going
to fucking bring something up like aliens to me.
Get ready to walk the walk.
Yeah.
Or don't talk
the talk. All I know Blink-182 is alien hunting. I obviously like aliens.
He goes, that's what he does when he goes alien hunting. He just goes, where are you?
He goes outside and screams that at the sky.
And they go, they don't like it. They go, I'm more of a Sum 41 guy.
We're Sum 41. That song fucking slaps, though.
That's one of my favorite terms of 2018, 2019, slaps, because it's so funny. And you know who I heard it using first? Pete Davidson.
Well, he probably meant it.
Yeah. Well, no, he was like, it was like a romantic video of Ariana Grande and him. And she's like, what songs do you like? And he's like, that song slaps. And she was like, baby. And he's like, what those?
I would be full fucking saying.
Start that off again. Start the beginning of it.
Oh, yeah, please.
Come on, Sum 41. It's about sweating all the is in the bike, I saw. No, not this. This is, there it is. Jump ahead of this. Yeah. Aliens were bumping this.
Definitely.
They're avoiding Blink-182.
They stole a duck.
These guys are crazy. These guys are crazy. Duck whispered. You know what's weird is to think of how many opiated deaths are in this audience.
Oh, yeah. Sure. This is back when it was still fun.
Yeah, this is like, oh, man, they got a new thing called OxyContin. And it's not addictive and it feels real good. It's like, because we lost our kids to the government. He goes, everybody, everyone thought it was a pain pill.
This was 01. My first Oxy death I had to deal with was like 07.
So funny. He goes, no. All my friends are going to die from pills, and there is nothing that we're going to do. Purdue Pharma just created an epidemic.
Wow.
Yeah, dude.
Like, yeah, take that, jocks.
Yeah, stupid jocks.
We're fucking Hot Topic dorks.
I mean, also so funny though, is you think that guy probably can scrap, but then the rest of them you're just rolling through. Sum 41, you can take out, can you take the whole band?
I don't know if all those guys are in the band. I think they're just like his hype men.
I think I could rock a decent amount of Sum 41.
Sum 41, you take out the whole band?
No.
Come on.
No.
I think you could. I think you got to worry about the drummer, maybe the psychotic guitar player.
One of them had to have, yeah, true. I could fucking rock that kid.
I mean,
yeah.
Blink-182, the only one I'm worried about is Barker. Maybe Hoppus because of his size. But I'm stepping through Blink-182.
I don't know.
Tom?
Yeah, dude.
Tom's hardcore into aliens.
Green Day? I'm giving them the time of their life.
Green Day, you could fucking rock.
I'll fuck Green Day up. I'll fuck Green Day up. Green Day comes up, I'm just like this. Ooh, Billy Joel, who wants it?
You know who I could definitely beat the fuck out of? You know who I could definitely beat the fuck out of? Queens of the Stone Age. They're fucking pussies. No, stop. Yo, chill.
What's up?
Chill, bro.
What's up? What's up? Yeah, you say Pearl Jam, Lou just scurries across like the ring. He's like
underneath the table.
Just pulls you like a shark. Yeah, dude, Queens of the Stone Age would fuck your shit up. Josh Homme's 6'6". Mean.
Yeah, Homme would get you.
He put hands on a dude. Lead singer of the Dwarves, was it?
Dwarves?
Yeah, he beat up this punk band in Detroit. Just beat the fuck out of this dude. I was like, yeah, it's my guy. Green Day, I'm walking through that. Maybe young Oakland Green Day is a problem.
Oh, man. Green Day, when Green Day got fucking all political, I wasn't like the biggest Green Day guy going into that, but
you know what song?
Like, you want to be an American idiot? Yeah, I was like, I'm a fucking American idiot, dude. You try to fucking tread on me?
Yeah.
You want to tread on me, Green Day?
I downloaded Brain Stew because I forgot how good it was.
Which one was that?
You'll know when Lou fucking gets that sweet, tasty riff up. See that? You hear those typing? That means it's coming. That means the storm's coming. What's up?
What's up, Denny's?
What's up? What the fuck is up, Denny's?
What the fuck is up, Denny's?
What the fuck is up, Denny's?
Damn.
Yeah, dude. Green Day should go play this in a Denny's.
Then I'd be all in.
Ripped off from the Chicago song. Jay told me about it. Was it 40?
Damn. Jay's autistic knowledge of music is needed right now.
It's unreal.
25, 6 to 4.
Jay just touches the desk and he sees every lyric ever written. He goes, all right, I'm in.
Well, Sam
his nose starts bleeding.
He's 11-ing it. I mean, it's cold. Chicago's cold. They see me. What is it? I'll play the Chicago. I'm having trouble trying to sleep. You go, hey, it's just a dream. It's 25.
They got a settlement.
They did.
Yeah, and it was the same thing. Sam Smith, he called it out. Sam Smith, the Stay With Me.
Yeah.
I like that song. He goes, it's Won't Back Down, Tom Petty. I don't like hacks.
Whoa.
And he got a settlement.
Damn. Jay knows. Jay's the dog. Jay's the detective.
Sam Smith's all right.
I like that song, but he did get a settlement from Won't Back Down. Just make the music and give him the settlement. That was Bittersweet Symphony.
Yeah, that song.
But they got wiped. The band got wiped from that settlement.
Latch by Sam Smith.
Mm-mm. Now you're Sam. I love that you go deep on Sam Smith. That's BBG bait.
Sam Smith's all right.
Is Sam Smith BBG music?
Used to be.
He was BB.
He was, yeah. When he came out, that was, he's a little older now.
Yeah, so, but when his first came
BBG's
out, it was all.
Only listened to people that are very, very young.
And like sad.
Great BBG song.
This is a BBG song?
Oh.
Is this like a sad song?
No, this is.
This is, makes you think of BBGs. Does it make you think of former BBGs? I want to know
Are
what makes
you getting emotional.
Yeah, because this to me sounds like a cologne
Does
commercial.
Does make you think of BBGs?
Yeah, this is
nah,
like.
You gotta wait till it fucking kicks in.
Come on, I could have told you he's gay right now.
No, that's not him, but the.
No, the singing.
Oh, I know this song.
Yeah, when this song kicks in, it's pretty fucking undeniably great.
Yeah, is it? It's a Sam song.
I don't think so.
I saw such hip playlist when I worked there.
Wait, let him do it. Let him do the heavy lifting. You already got put over.
Shut up.
Let him do it.
I do like
wow.
this song.
This song fucking is
I don't
great.
Know. I'm kind of turning.
Turn it up a little. This song fucking ooh. Ooh, I'm going to fucking pulse.
You're going to pulse all over?
Ooh. I'm gonna
fucking
ooh. Yes, dude. Everyone listening to this
I
right
like
now.
I like the glittering lasers.
Yes.
Man.
Yeah.
This is yes. definite hot Please. People fuck to this music.
Hot people dance to it. They yeah. fuck to it. What a life.
What a life Here they live. They just sweating, taking pictures. Oh, I remember this. This is such a BBG song. This yeah. is Hot Baby Girls. This is like Pied Piper music.
Yep.
You can probably this. Get them to walk down the street.
Yeah.
It's following.
Yeah.
Like,
where are we going? Are we
Roll
going
your down? Windows down. Yeah. Play this.
Here you go.
Okay, catch them.
Just do that. You go.
Yeah. Oh, my God.
Yeah, there you go.
We gotta go. There's a brunch special. This is party brunch music. Like somebody's totally gonna is. Come out with a big old.
What if I told you there is bottomless mimosas down the street with some eggs?
Follow me.
You should. I just fucking to this would be so funny if I tried to fuck. To
oh my
this.
God! You'd be all off rhythm. You'd be like, fuck. Don't fuck. Look at me. Don't look at me. But look at me now. Look at me now.
It's fucking hot. It's hot in this room.
Did I get sweat on you? Sorry. Fuck. Oh fuck. Fuck. Hold on. Hold on. Just move your leg. Move your leg. You're trying to.
Why'd you tell your friends I sucked at sex?
Yeah, that hurt. That hurt.
Now it's in my head every time we fuck. God damn it.
Hold on.
God. Almost, I'm soft
your
again.
My face.
I'm soft.
Your hair's my face. Because I'm nervous.
I'm soft again.
It's just that. You don't even say you're soft. You just go, I don't know. I'm fucking. The song sucks.
Who cares? I can finish semi.
All right. Just, do you want me to. Help me out. Help me out. Put me in you.
You got to get. Come on.
Put me in.
Do it with your hand. I can't hold up. Can't hold myself up with one hand.
Yeah. I don't see where I'm going. I'm just poking into nothing. You gotta guide me. Guide me.
Yeah, suck it in.
Guide it. All right, hold on. Does that hurt? Well, I can't put. Where am I supposed to put the weight? I have to put it somewhere.
Fucking songs over.
Songs. All right. Hold on. Do you want me to turn off the TV?
If I get up, I'm losing my heart on.
You have to suck my dick if I get up. If I get up, you're gonna have to blow me hard again. Is that? Do you want to do that? Real sex talk during Sam's. Here you go. Listen, if we you come in too hot, you come in too hot, I'm going to come fast. Listen, you did too good. Yeah. Here you go. All right. All right. You know he's gay?
It's a rhythm.
You
know he's fucking gay?
You know he's gay?
Oh, fuck it. I would never be gay.
And then you come. You know, he's gay. Fucking losing it.
I would never be gay. God damn, I keep going soft, though. I don't know what that's about.
You mind if I flick the old traps? You mind if I get some trapezoids
Fuck,
on
I'm
you?
Breaking the... This is a shitty bed frame.
I go, do you think Kyle can hear us?
I hope Kyle can hear us.
Yeah, you go, fuck, I like your brother, but I don't want him to be weirded out. I'm going to put you in the right place. Put you in the right place. Oh, Sam Smith, you're...
I'm going to get you there. I'm going to get you. I'm going to get you where you need to be.
I'm going to deliver the package. I'm waiting, yeah. Is it a business date? Is it a business date?
Can I finish in you? No. Okay. No again.
Okay.
No again.
Okay. I'm soft. I'm sorry. I don't know what it is. I'm sorry. You saying no like that, I thought I made you mad. So you hungry at all? Or oh, yeah. We got to go. Shane Gillis, Matt and, yes. Matt and Shane's Secret Podcast.
Yes.
I love you.
I love you.
Thanks for guest hosting.
I love all you guys.
You'll be guest hosting with Jay Wam in Scotland.
Oh, yeah. Bro.
Letting in the way of the sword.
Bro. You're gonna murder
ShaneMGillis.com for live dates. Download Matt and Shane's Secret Podcast. And if you're in Montreal, go see Big J at the Nasty Show tonight, through the 27th. We're going to be doing those live bonfire shows Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday from the Doubletree, Soprano C Room, 6 to 8 p.m.
Get you where you need to be.
Get you where you need to be. I'm going to be doing my live show Monday through Thursday. So if you're in Montreal and want to come see me run the hour, you know, before I go to Scotland and I'll UK it up. DanceHunter.com, BigJComedy.com, CC.com/bonfire. The crew, I love you guys. I won't be seeing you till September. Be gone till September.
Damn.
No?
Oh, man. Yep. Bye, guys.
Wow.
I love you, White Lou. I love you, Black Lou. I love you, Becky Rodriguez, even though you don't like me and you think I just do voices. Christine. See. I'm kidding. I love you,
Becky. Are you going to be back for my 9/11 party?
Hell yeah, dude. I would never forget. Shane. I would never forget.
You're going to come over?
How you doing? Dan Soder.
Billy. Hey, it's me a lot.
Oh, God. You guys are really taking down the towers of this party.
Wow, that's so sick. I'm going to get you guys so much pussy for this.
Oh, my God. So much virgin pussy. We love you guys. Crackle, crackle.
Bye.
If you don't know numbers, you don't know business. That's the problem growing businesses have because of a hodgepodge of business systems. One for accounting, one for sales, one for an inventory. If that's you, you know it's a mess that takes up too much time and too many resources. That hurts the bottom line. You need NetSuite by Oracle, the cloud-based business management software that gives you the visibility and control you need to grow. With NetSuite, you save time, money, and unneeded headaches by managing skills, finance, and accounting, orders, and HR instantly from your desktop or your phone. That's why NetSuite is the world's number one cloud business system. Companies that use NetSuite grow 3 times faster than the S&P 500. And right now, NetSuite is offering you valuable insights with a free guide, 7 key strategies to growing your profits at netsuite.com/ccbf. That's netsuite.com/ccbf to download your free guide of 7 key strategies to grow your profits. netsuite.com/ccbf.